See, and that's the thing about some of us is we want to see everybody as our mutual. I put my pants on just like Mark Jones. We want to see everybody as our mutual. And the essence of mentorship is that I'm not your mutual. I am under you in the Lord in terms of flow, in terms of instruction, in terms of experience. And I believe that attitude, there are people around this man who don't get what I get from him. And here's why. Posture. Mentorship is about a posture. It's about understanding that somebody is in your life to help you remain focused and to help you remain straight, to make sure you don't get bent and crooked. As the apostle said, we need accountabilities in our life. I don't care who you are, what you oversee, how much experience you have. Everybody needs somebody who's not intimidated with their success or their progress, who will speak the truth to them in love. And so I do believe that one of the major pitfalls is that we get developed to a place we take ourselves off the wheel.
Wow.
That's what I believe. And I don't care how long you've been in ordained ministry, you should never take yourself off the wheel of development, off the wheel of accountability. Wow. Apostle, potential pitfalls for those coming into ministry.
Wow.
God bless you all. We wouldn't mind talking this. I thank God for being here. Well, it was a fight, but I'm here. The potential pitfalls for those that come to ministry. Well, we have to always remember the order of God. God has an order. It's a heavenly order. And when you look at God, God is the spiritual authority. He is the authority. Jesus is God's delegated authority. The pastoral leaders are God's, Jesus' delegated authority. And moving on down, when we see the importance of submitting to delegated authority, then we begin to understand how the gospel flows. We always must learn to pull on those. If we don't pull on the anointing, you'll never get anything to pull on, but you got to first respect. The key is so important. Everybody's going to be in a society and a world where everybody's about themselves. And it's filtered over into the ministries. Everybody about them, about my success, about my this and my that. And that spirit of individualism has caused us to lose the compassion needed for the end-time ministry. It's all about me, my, and mine. And one thing I do appreciate about Dr. Mark is the fact that though he is moving in those spheres and those arenas, there is a unique quality in him that he respects me. You must identify who your spiritual father is, and that spiritual father must not be intimidated with you. I don't care where you go, but when you get the outgrow yourself, you have to stay in the attitude of a child. A child always learns, okay. My philosophy in this 47 years of ministry is I don't know nothing. Even though I know I don't know. So then when I come in an environment, one that has a superior spirit over me, then I learn what they know plus what I know, it makes me better. But when I flaunt my knowledge and flaunt my success, that's immaturity. And so God's trying to bring the body into maturity. Well, perfection means maturity. That you can be able to learn to lean, and in this new age, if the new age don't catch itself, we're going to lose a whole lot because we got this spirit of entitlement on us, somebody owes something, and that's just really not how it goes. You got to pay the price. If you're willing to suffer, you can reign. If you're willing to serve, you can become a master. And most folk don't want to serve. They see all this, but they don't see the glory. They see the glory, but they don't see the price. And there's a price behind glory. And so what I suggest to those that are getting into ministry, it's not about the next appreciation service. It's just really not about the glamour and the first lady and the second lady and the third lady. It's about you. You know, it's really sickening to see people come into ministry for the wrong reason. You got when you're in one row, you got 20 churches and 3 people. It's not about building an independent organization so you can get some glory and the souls still go to hell. But if we learn how to come up on the one voice, and don't be, I'm not intimidated by any of these apostles. I've been in the ministry longer than they were living. But the point of that is that when we learn how to work together to help the kingdom of the gospel and every vineyard become, it's a shame that me and Apostle got to go outside of Tampa to get affirmation. Because people here who call themselves apostles, call themselves preachers, can't get with you because they don't want to embrace, they don't want to embrace the glory that's upon your life.
My God.
But one thing I've learned, you might be a hater, but you can't stop the process.